Guys, I just picked up so much coral!
Okay guys, so the first thing to do when you know you're gonna get coral in is make some nice fresh salt water. That way you can use it for dipping and a second dip as well when you rinse it off. That way they have nice clean water. Also, this way you can replace the water you're using for the dip right back into the tank without having to worry about salinity. Here's the coral dipping station. It's 2 1-gallon ice cream tubs. So the bucket on the left will actually be our dipping bucket. So what I like to do is do at least half of the water from the tank, and then the rest of it will be from the actual coral bags. And then the bucket on the right will actually be our rinse off bucket. It'll house brand new fresh salt water that we were mixing, plus the Brightwell Restore and the iodide. Here's the haul. This one's a strawberry shortcake. This one has really nice green skin and pink tips. This one's called the banana hammock. It actually has some really nice colors that's gonna shine through once it grows out in the colony. Next up is the northern lights tenuous. This one looks really nice, especially under blues. It'll have nice pink coral lights. And next is the fruitopia. So this one is super colorful once it grows out. I'm really excited, and hopefully it grows into a nice colony. Next is Rainbow Loom. Now this one is also another colorful SPS coral. And of course, the classic Green Slimer. These are easy, or they should be easy to grow, and they're super bright. So very first step, as this picture shows, you need to float your corals, and I do that for at least an hour. All right, now we're doing our dip. I like to dip using Milifix and Coral RX Pro. I like to do majority of it Milifix and then a few more drops with the Coral RX Pro, and the pests seem to just slide right off, like Disasterina right here. Now, I normally dip SPS corals for a max of 10 minutes in this solution, and I'll swirl it around, mix it all up every now and then. Blast them a little bit with the turkey baster to see if anything will fall off after marinating for a while. Now, I recommend swapping out plugs due to the fact that you never know what's going to be on someone else's frag plugs. You don't want to risk having some type of eggs or anything and having a pest just explode in your tank all of a sudden. You just don't want that burden, so I highly recommend always swapping out the frag plugs, even if they're encrusted. I just cut them right off and put them on the brand new frag plug. Here I'm giving it one last swirl in the dip to make sure that all the pests that I can see or not see will get off. Now I always give them one good shake with the tweezers before placing them into the second bucket, which is a mixture of iodine and Restore. Now I'll let them soak in this solution for about 10 minutes or so, and then swap out the plugs. All right, just giving you an idea before placing them into the tank of how they're gonna look, their colors and everything. They're gonna be super nice up in here, guys. I'm super excited. They're gonna be great. Now, in preparation for all these corals I'm getting, there's gonna be another part two to this video. I got a 32 frag plug rack. This way it can accommodate all the corals that I'm getting in. Okay, so what I'm doing here is I'm taking the frag rack all the way down to the sand bed to allow these corals to acclimate to my tank, the parameters, and the lighting. So every day, I'm just gonna nudge it up little by little until we get to about the top of the rock, and they should be acclimated to the light, and I should be able to glue them down in certain areas, and they should be happy and thrive. Too much change too fast can kill SPS corals, and you really don't want to do that. So, slow is best with these types of corals. Go slow with the lighting and keep your parameters as stable as possible. Especially with dosing and alkalinity, you want to make sure that's stable as possible. And the more sticks you add, the more consumption will take place. So it's super, super important to keep your alkalinity in check and keep an eye on it. I test daily because these sticks just soak it up. Hey guys, just want to say thanks for stopping by. Thank you so much to my returning subscribers. And if you're new, thinking about sticking around, hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, and guys, leave me a comment. I want to know, how do you dip your SPS corals, if you have them, or your dipping regimen in general. Thanks again, guys. And just remember, just reef. Oh, I almost forgot. I have so much more coral to show you. If you are on my Instagram, you already know about it, but holy cow, guys, wait for that video. I can't wait to show you. See ya.